In this lecture, we will have a look at source transformation technique. Voltage source. Okay, we have a voltage source. I am applying this for DC sources. Okay, we have a DC voltage source and it is having a voltage of V and a resistance R. Right. That is, we are considering a realistic voltage source, not an ideal one. So this is equivalent to what? An ideal voltage source with voltage V in series with a resistance R. Right. Let's consider these ports to be A and B. Again, A, B. So the idea of source transformation technique is that you can convert this into a current source in parallel with the resistance. Again, this will be A and B. So there will be let's denote this as RV. Okay, there will be a current I and a resistance RI. So what we have to do, we have to find the value of I and RI. So we know Ohm's law, V equal to IR, right? And what will be the current across this resistance if we were to close this loop? That is the current that we will get here. So it will be I equal to V by R. Again here, what is the R here? RV. Okay. So again, I equal to this I equal to V by RV. Okay. And what will RV be? RV is the resistance across this terminal when we are replacing this voltage source with its ideal internal impedance, which is a short circuit. Therefore, the equivalent resistance across this terminal will be RV, right? R, we will get it at RV. So sorry, here it is RI. Again, because we are considering these two ports, right? These two are same ports. So the resistance seen across these ports, right, these should be same, right? Resistance seen across AB should be same, and the current that we are getting out of it should be same, and the voltage that we are getting across it should be same. That is the basic idea of source transformation. That is, even though we are changing from a voltage source in series to a current source in parallel with the resistance, the effect that we are getting at the terminal should not change. So to make for that, here RI should be equal to RV, right? RI should be equal to RV. So RI equal to RV. This will be the same when we are converting this way. Okay, we can convert this way. We can convert this way. If we are converting from a current source in parallel with the resistance to a voltage source in series to a resistance, what will it be? V equal to I R, right? RI, and RV will be equal to RI, right? So let me just write this formally. Basically, we can convert a V, I'm just using the same R here, across AB. This is equivalent to AB here, RI, and here V is equal to IR and I is equal to V by R, right? So if you are converting this way, that is, if you are converting voltage source to current source, then we will write I equal to V by R. R is the same as here. And if you are converting a current source to a voltage source, we write V equal to I R. Again, R is the same here. This is the basic source transformation technique. Technique is what is it, what's its inspiration is, but how do we use it, or where do we use it? What is the point of just transforming a voltage source into a current source and vice versa? What is the point? The thing is, we can greatly simplify networks or circuits, and we can solve problems without going into complicated mesh or loop equations. So let's see a question here. So we have a 10 volt here, 2 ohm here, 3 ohm here, and 5 volt here, 1 ohm here, and we denote this current as I. The question is, find I using source transformation technique. So how do we do this? What we do is, we first of all, we convert this into a current source, and we convert this into a current source. So the equivalent will be what? We have our I here, our 1 ohm here. So basically, we have transformed this voltage source in series with the resistance into a current source in parallel with the resistance. So what will be the, first of all, what will be the direction of this current? Here the current was going like this, right? Because we are transforming across this terminal, right? Basically, the current should come here. So again, the current should come through here, and the direction will be like this. So as a rule of thumb, you can say that the positive and negative of the voltage source and current source should match. And if the positive is here, the current direction should be like this. Okay. The value of R is 2 ohm, no change here. What will be the value of I equal to V by R, which is 5 ampere. Again, we are applying the same thing here, which is a resistance and a current source. Okay. So the resistance will be 3, and this will be, what will this be? 5 by 3 ampere, 3 ohm. Simple, same thing that we did here. Again, just have noticed the direction of the current owing to the polarity of the voltage source. Now what do we do? Now basically what is happening is, in parallel, in opposite directions, right? We have two current sources in parallel in opposite direction. So what we can do is, we can, because they are in parallel, like we can add voltage sources in series, we can add current sources in parallel. And here it so happens that both of them are in they are in the opposite direction, so we have to find the difference and replace the whole thing with one current source. And we have 5 upwards and 5 by 3 downwards. So ultimately, it will be 10 by 3 amperes upwards. And since we want to find the current through this branch, we are not touching it. We are letting it be. We are not disturbing it. What we do next is, we find the equivalent resistance of these two. They are in parallel, right? 2 and 3. So we find the equivalent resistance of 2 and 3, which is 6 by 5. 6 by 5 ohm, and we have our 1 ohm in parallel with this. Now how will we find I equal to 10 by 3 into what? 10 by 3 into 6 by 5 by 6 by 5 plus 1. current by 3 amperes come here, it divides into 2, and from that we are finding the value of I, which is equal to 20 by 11 ampere. Right, so basically what we are doing is we are changing to find some value, voltage or current or something across a certain element, we are changing the other elements around it. We are not disturbing this element, right? Please notice that we are not disturbing this element, we are changing everything around it to suit the problem. Okay, to suit the problem we are changing everything around it, and once you get a hold of this, once you start practicing it, this will become much faster. Okay, now let's see one more question. The other way of transforming. So we have a current source here in parallel with the resistance, 9 ampere, 2 ohm, 5 ampere, 4 ohm, 30 volt, 4 ampere, 2 ohm. So the question is to find V0. Okay, so as per our earlier problem, what do? We do not change or affect this branch, right? So this much we will keep it as it is, and from here you can identify a simple pattern, right? You can convert this and you can convert this. So what do? V equal to IR, so this will be 18 volt, 2 ohm again, V equal to IR, 8 volt, 2 ohm, 10 volt, 2 ohm, and 4 ohm, 30 volt, V0. Right. So then what do we have to find? All we have to do is we have to find first, we have to find the current, right? So we'll just assume the current to be I, and we'll just write the equation. So it will be minus 10 minus 18 plus 8 plus 30. So I just wrote all the voltages together, plus I into 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 4 equal to 0. I just collected all the resistances together and all the voltages together. So from this we will get I equal to minus 1 ampere. Okay. So I equal to minus 1 ampere. So this will be minus 28 plus 8 plus minus 28 plus 8 minus 20 plus 10. This will be plus 10 and this will be plus 10. So this plus 10 will go here, will be minus 10 by plus 10 will be minus 1 ampere. Implies what is V0? V0 equal to I into, right? Here we are taking the current direction and voltage direction such that it matches. So I into resistance, which is 4 ohm. This is minus 4 volt. It is minus 4 volt means the polarity of the voltage is opposite. It will be like this. It will be 4 volt like this. That is the meaning of this. So earlier problem, we converted the voltage sources into current sources and found the resultant current. And here we converted the current sources into voltage sources and found out the resultant voltage. a different pattern. Okay, we have a 2 ohm here, again a 2 ohm here, 1 ohm Ix, this is 2 Ix, so this is a current dependent current source, 4 ohm here and a 10 volt. Question is find Ix. Okay, so here again since the Ix value is here, we cannot disturb this arm. Right, we shouldn't disturb this arm. We can we'll apply the source transformation to this area, whatever is coming here. So the idea is first we will apply it to here. Okay, then we'll add on these two. Okay, the thing to be noted here is that yes, we can apply source transformation to dependent sources provided we do not disturb the branch which is having controlling value, which is the Ix here. We don't, and as long as we don't affect this, we can use source transformation for a dependent source. So how will this be? This much doesn't change. Okay, Ix 1 ohm 10 volt. So again I'm just applying it here for the first time. We have a 4 ohm here, so this will become a voltage source in series, right? So this is 2 ohm, again 2 ohm, V equal to IR, so 2 Ix into 2 will be 4 Ix. Now this became a current controlled voltage source, right? Now what do? We have to we can again simplify. We can just combine these two, and then it will be a voltage source in series with one resistance. Then we can convert this whole thing into a current source. So that is what we will do here. So again 1 ohm Ix 10 volt 4 ohm, because the current direction is from this source will be coming like this way downwards, our current source will be producing a current downwards, and this will be, this resistance will be 2 plus 2 4 ohm, and I equal to V by R, so 4 Ix by 4, which is Ix. Okay, now again this is a little bit more complicated. We need one more transformation, which will be, we'll combine this 4 ohm and 4 ohm into a 2 ohm resistance, and from there we will combine this whole thing into a voltage source in series with a resistance. So again this much doesn't change, 10 volt 1 ohm Ix, so, and we have something like this, right? We have something like this, and the polarity will be this way because the current should go downwards. Again 4 in parallel, it becomes 2 ohm, and this is how much is this, V equal to IR, which is 2 into Ix, 2 Ix, right? Now we can simply write the loop equation and solve, which will be minus 10 plus Ix into 1 plus 2 minus 2 Ix equal to 0, right? From that what do we get? We get Ix equal to 10 ampere. Just simply writing the loop equation and solve it. Otherwise, had we gone for some nodal or loop equation, it might have taken some more time. Here, okay, we had some 2-3 steps of transformation, but it is much simpler. Okay, so with this, I am winding up this lecture on source transformation technique. More problems will be posted in the classroom. Thank you.